anytime you're on the court, you know, with a Big 12 team, I think at one point was ranked in the top five in the country with one of the transcendent college basketball stars of the last several years. Man, it's just a pleasure to be out there in such an exciting setting, and to win the game the way we want it, having the chances at the end of regulation to win it, and then having to show the character, to close it out in overtime just makes it, even more exhilarating. That was a great moment.
You called EC the pioneer of everything when you get this thing going. To see him have a game like this, what does it mean to you?
That's how that should have went. I mean, that's how that, talk about a guy that's had to climb mountain after mountain, adversity across the board. He deserved that moment. He deserved a chance to play again on Saturday on the biggest stage, and he may have a little bit more magic left. We played pretty good in the city.
Fats Russell as a freshman, guarding Trae Young, huge three-pointers. Did that surprise you at all with what he's done all year?
No, not a second. Are you kidding me? I mean, if you see this kid, day in and day out, that's a special young man. Any other situation, if he's playing 30 minutes a game, he's one of the best freshman guards in the country. He's a spectacular player. We were communicating last night. I knew he was going to show up big today. He had that look in his eye, and he had that big smile. And when you see that smile, something's about to happen.
Fats told me that he didn't even know that Duke was in the same bracket in this town. So what do you tell the guys now? Obviously, it's not official yet, but if you're going to go up against a powerhouse like Duke.
Yeah, we don't really tell them anything. We watch their team, play. We do a real quick scout. We got a quick turnaround here. We formulate a game plan, and it's a one-day prep. So it's gonna be a player's game on Saturday. Obviously, playing Duke in around the 32 is a special, unique opportunity for any program. We know the challenges that they present. With the greatness of Coach K and the greatness of their team and players. But I mean, what more can you ask for than a chance to play a game like that and now get a chance to play the winner of Iona Duke?
Fats said before he got to Rhode Island, defense wasn't something that he really enjoyed. That wasn't something he took a lot of pride in. How much does that mean to you to have a kid come in as a freshman and now a few months later he's guarding the best player in the country?
I mean, it's the program's built around defense and making our opponent uncomfortable. And you win championships, you advance in this tournament, you build programs around being a good to great defensive team and by being one of the hardest playing teams in the country. And that's not hard to get a guy from Philly to buy into. Fats is a super confident kid that believes in himself and does whatever it takes to win. He's been incredible the whole year.
Coach Bill Koch informed us that you're the lone URI coach to win multiple seasons of tournament games. What does that mean for you?
It means a lot. It's hard to get in the NCAA tournament. There's a lot of great teams that that didn't get included in this year's field. It took us a long time in between appearances until last year. It's for me, it's important. I want to be that coach that's able to do something special somewhere. That's important to me, to have a program that's ascending every year and doing things that haven't been done before.
When you put a team together and then you have a win like this where each of those building blocks seems to contribute to the victory, just what's that feeling like knowing that you feel like you built the right team for this moment?
And it's, we're a senior laden team with the four senior starters, but some of our biggest heroes today are underclassmen, sophomore players that'll be back with us, again next year. And having getting the experience, Jeff Dowden, Cyril Langevin, I screwed it up sometimes too. Fats Russell, they were some of our best players today that led us to victory. So, the seniors were amazing. They've carried us all year, but that's why we feel comfortable that it's going to be kind of a new normal for us on the stage every year.
For the viewing public, maybe the non-URI fans, first day, first game, overtime, really set the tone for the tournament.
Yeah, there was some pressure. I said, we were talking as coaches. It's like you want the biggest stage possible, But watching those clips of Trae Young, it's a little bit scary. If things got out of control with him, this could have got a little bit ugly, for us. I guess that's your worst case scenario thinking. But They put us at that 12-15. I think the committee knew that this was going to be an exciting matchup. We have the great group of guards, and then, you know, the transcendent college player. It was, you know, I don't imagine that we had very bad ratings on that game.
Fats was trending on Twitter midway through the game. Do you think the nation is finally seeing what Rhode Island and Kingston has been seeing this entire season?
Yeah, well, I think he was after Providence, too. So, you know, I have my wife take screenshots of that so I can send it to him, just so that, you know, we keep that confidence nice and high. He's a spectacular player. The steal and then the three in a game of that magnitude, you know, what can you say?
How about with that long three by Jared in the second half, too? It seemed like he hit that from the river, from the bridge.
Yeah, I mean, the first half, I mean, we were, you know, I don't know what we ended up with. I think maybe 16 assists, 6 turnovers. I mean, we were moving the ball and getting great threes in the first half that we just weren't making. But, you know, and then for that three to go down there was kind of like, well, hey, fellas, we keep missing these open ones. I guess basketball gods kind of owed us that deep one. And then, but that kind of settled down the group, you know. Jared's our alpha, along with EC, and we needed him to make a big shot.
Coach, you invested these guys in this town. You mentioned the magic in Pittsburgh. I think you've won in every building in this town. You won here in the A-10 last year. You win here. What has it meant to you to see the reception that you got in Pittsburgh and to see your team perform so well in front of this crowd?
Yeah, we knew. I mean, I kept telling the guys for the last month, 6 weeks, you know, we will be in Pittsburgh. I don't know what seed we're going to be, but this is just a way that this thing's going to play out. We've had great success here. You know, it's a great basketball. You know, they love their basketball here, you know, and once we saw that Pittsburgh flash, I think the guys felt really good about it. I know I did.
Coach, we noticed that towards the end of the second half there, it looks like you were trying to play Stan Robinson on defense, and then when you got the ball back, you were taking him out and playing Jared Torello. Was that part of the game plan originally?
Yeah, just we had foul trouble. Jared had 4, so we were, you know, Jared's been, you know, closer and, you know, our leading scorer the whole year, so we were trying to manage those minutes and obviously keep Fats in the game because he was such a game breaker out there. And those guys handled those situations beautifully. Stan played an underrated, great game.
The push-ups, is that an every game thing or is it an NCAA thing? Or
listen, I work out 6 days a week, man. I just, I guess, showing off a little bit. And I didn't know what to do. I can't dance. So.